Hi, I'm Vic, and welcome to Geeko Farm, where we do things differently. This time, with fire. Yes, first word of warning, we're using this stuff, which is pipe, cement and solvent, which has been determined in the state of paranoia to cause cancer. So, be careful with it. Normally you'd wear nitrile gloves or something, but I'm going to set fire to things, so I'm wearing leather gloves, and I'll wash my hands afterwards. But first, when you're teaching people to shoot clay pigeons, they're concerned about the recoil of a standard 12-gauge cartridge. So I've developed this light 28-gauge load. All right, back to the pool. What this is all about, you see, is the Pool of Doom. You may remember that from an earlier episode. A link.
It's the Pool of Doom.
The motor that is used in the pump here, so this blue bit there, blew a capacitor in there. I replaced the capacitor and now the motor runs really hot to the point where the paint smokes, so that one's buggered. So we'll get a new one installed, but we had a bit of a problem in that all the connectors were the wrong type. And yeah, they were all glued on very short stubs of pipe, so I couldn't cut it and join it on again, so hence burning pipe trick. Anyway, the procedure for getting a joint off a PVC pipe, tricky one, but we can do it. We start off by using a Dremel to slit the connector on the pipe and then to slit the body of the connector that is actually stuck to the pipe. This will give us somewhere to lever it off through. Now the hairy bit. So this is the solvent. Sorry about the angle. I want to be really sure I don't get this stuff on me accidentally. We put on the lovely goopy solvent all over the place. I've done this on a wet pipe as well. It still works if the pipe's a little bit wet inside. That might help stop the whole thing set on fire. Anyway. There we go. So that's all that done. And now the lid is securely on, as I say. We set it on fire. I'm going to have to move a bit fast after this. Don't have much time, mate. There we go. That looks glorious, doesn't it? Oh, yeah. Well singed up the pipe at the back. Anyway, screwdriver. Fairly obviously, it's important to make sure that all the fires are out before you apply it for the second time. May of course be fire leaking inside, lurking inside the tube that you haven't spotted yet. Think of this as a sort of plumbing version of a flambé, where you, when you cook things, you try to get the alcohol inside them. We're trying to get the solvent cooked inside the pipe. And this is the most convenient way of doing it, and also quite fun. Oh yeah, that's looking better. It's starting to bubble up on top now. Ah, yes. Try not to touch it with the hands, of course, because of aforementioned toxic qualities of the blue stuff. But there we have ta-da! A fitting removed from a pipe using glue. Thank you. I'm also available for weddings and bar mitzvahs. Quick skip forward. They've cooled off and the solvent's evaporated now. As you can see, I managed to undo the joint quite successfully. There were actually a couple I had to do, and that one put up more of a fight. Anyway, back to the pool. So I managed to get all the couplings on the right way around, which is good. Nice double-ended sucker. That's connected, set to slow. We open up the valves at both ends. I keep forgetting to do the both ends part, which is bad. Right. So that was loose. All right, well, not much for it now, but here we go. And water hoses out of there.
The water coming out the other end I'm worried about.
All right.
And now I know where my moving part went.
Yeah. Not too bad for a first attempt.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, sometimes it goes wrong. Still, saves me washing all that toxic stuff off me. Yeah. But for now, that's your lot. Down on Geeko Farm. Yep, still pumped.